So when we have board meetings, at the end of every board meeting, first of all, sometimes someone from the company is just invited to come to the board meeting who isn't on the board, just so they can actually participate and enjoy the process and learn from it. But regardless, we always take really copious notes and then send those notes out to the entire company after the fact. We have a weekly planning meeting that includes me, Dustin, our head of engineering, and our head of business. And there are certainly some things like HR issues where it's not our prerogative to share that with the whole company. Not going to share salaries. That's really their personal information to share. But for almost everything else, we take copious notes, send those notes out to everyone in the company. And sometimes it starts a dialogue where people are like, actually, you know, I think that decision you made, you know, you should consider this other option. Sometimes we, you know, either engage in dialogue or sometimes just say, you know, we can't respond to every single thing. But for the most part, that creates this really collaborative process where people can have a lot of trust that we're thinking about the right things and making the right decisions. And so the effect of that is, you know, one, trust, and I think just sort of has a lot of value kind of in and of itself. But I think one of the coolest things that you get from this kind of radical transparency is that it means that people are empowered with enough knowledge that they don't have to be micromanaged and told, this is exactly what you should do, and this is exactly how you should do your job. You couldn't even micromanage people at the level of detail required. Like, even when you're writing an individual if statement or making an individual decision about some caching scheme, or certainly all the time in little product design details, there's understanding the bigger picture, understanding who is the customer, how are we trying to serve them, what are the market conditions we're under, what are the ways in which we're trying to advance our brand, can go down to the tiniest little decisions. And so by focusing more on providing people with context about their work, context about the overall goals of the company, context around our values and how we think it's good to make decisions, rather than trying to control people's actions and control people's decisions, we find that that leads to them being able to be much more effective. And not surprisingly, it means that we can hire people who are much more seasoned and senior, who are excited about contributing in a way that's that respects the fact that they are peers. In fact, I lied. There's a fourth value, and that's the fourth one. Company as collective of peers. We make a point. I think one thing to point out is that I think in the last maybe 10 years or so, this is a pretty recent phenomenon, even in Silicon Valley, maybe even 5 years, there's been this real fetishization of entrepreneurship. In fact, you have people like Paul Graham who are bordering on telling people you're a chump if you go work for another company. I think this is really ludicrous. Sometimes the most leveraged way to impact things is to start your own project. But a lot of the times, there are just so many great ideas out there, the opportunity to play a big role in making those things a reality is just as interesting. And we're all visionaries if we have environments that allow us to come together and collaborate. And I can see how people have come to this conclusion, because traditional companies are run in this way, where there's a really strong two-class structure, where you have the visionaries on top making all the decisions, and they're, you know, sometimes they're peons going on out and executing. But we have the privilege of we're able to hire just extraordinary people who definitely could be running their own companies, but instead we've come together and created this kind of super group. And so one example of a practice we use to try to respect us as a company of peers is Roadmap Week. So every, basically quarter, we divide them into episodes instead of quarters, which are kind of an episode of this is what we want to accomplish in the next few months or so. At the end of each of these episodes, we have a roadmap week where the whole company more or less stops doing normal work. And instead, everyone is in a bunch of different committees. So you just have 1 week of meetings all day, or for all week. What's nice about this, of course, is that we have a lot fewer meetings during the rest of the quarter. So it's, again, this sort of rhythm of concentrated meetings, and then concentrated fewer meetings. And in these committee meetings, we'll have a committee about mobile and our mobile strategy. We'll have a committee about our values. We'll have a committee about how we're going to expand the design team, a committee about the recruiting team. And sometimes these committees consist of the people that you'd expect of. Sometimes they consist of people who are, you know, someone in the customer support team who's read all the mobile complaints and so wants to be in that meeting so that it can be the voice of the customer. And those committees are given, again, a lot of context ahead of time on the overall values and how we kind of broadly see something like mobile fitting in with our strategy. But it's up to the committee to reflect on where are we now, where could we be going, what are the different options, what are the pros and cons of those different options, given those pros and cons, what is our evaluation of how we should step forward, what, you know, who are the right people to work on this, what are our requirements, what resources do we need. And they just put forth this plan for the next quarter for what we should do. sometimes there'll be, you know, all the committees will have more work than we could possibly do, so we have to sort of cut things a little bit. But in general, those committees are not, you know, really are making the decision. In theory, Dustin or I could override them and say, no, no, you've missed the mark entirely, we should do this other thing, but that's never actually happened. We really trust people to just make the right decisions, collect input from the right people within the company, and then we go forward with those as the plans of record. So that's, I think, a much better situation for everyone.